Hello friends, today I am here with another interesting recipe, that is Sichuan chili potatoes. If you are an Indo-Chinese food lover, this is a must try recipe for you. It's spicy, crispy from outside and very soft from inside. This hot and spicy dish is going to make you crave for more. This is an awesome appetizer for any parties or get together. There is a small tip to maintain the crispiness of these potatoes, which I'll be teaching this in this video. So watch till the end and let's get into the recipe now. Let's see the ingredients to chop. These are 2 big onions cubed, 1 medium sized capsicum which are also cubed, 1 teaspoon of finely chopped ginger and 2 green chilies. Here I have 5 medium sized potato which I have cut into wedges and soaked inside water to prevent it from oxidizing and getting brown. Add some water in a pan and 2 to 3 teaspoons of salt. Mix this well until dissolved. When it comes to boil, you have to add the potatoes. Now the water has started to boil. Let's add the potatoes. Keep the heat in medium and cook this for 5 minutes. Do not cover the lid and cook. Let this be open and make sure this is not cooked 100%. This step is to ensure that the potatoes have absorbed enough salt and ensures crispiness after frying. The potatoes are boiling since 5 minutes now. Immediately drain the water to prevent it from further cooking. And again make sure the potatoes are not 100% cooked. It should cook just 20%. Into the drained potatoes, add a teaspoon of crushed pepper, 3 to 4 tablespoons of all-purpose flour or maida, 1.5 tablespoon of corn flour. If you don't have corn flour, you can also use rice flour. And lastly, some chili powder according to your taste. Mix this well and make sure everything is well combined. Be gentle while mixing because you don't want to break the potato wedges. We have not added salt in this stage because the potato have already got enough salt. Into this add just 2 or 3 tablespoons of water and again gently mix this. If you feel the mixture is too dry at this stage, you can add a tablespoon or a couple of tablespoons more of water into this and mix well. Now it's all done and this should be the consistency. Heat oil to fry the potato wedges. The oil should not be too much hot. Drop the potatoes one by one and fry them until golden brown. If the oil is too hot, only the outer coating of the potato will get browned quickly and inside won't be cooked properly. So always make sure the oil is medium in heat while frying these potatoes. This will take about 4 to 5 minutes until done. You have to fry these for 2 times. So for the first time, you have to make sure the potatoes are completely cooked from inside and golden brown from outside. This is fine for the first time. Drain this into a paper towel. This is all done now. You have to fry this one more time just before serving. So keep this aside until we prepare the sauce. Heat oil in a pan and when it's hot, fry ginger and green chilies. Just fry it for a minute in a medium heat. Add onion and capsicum together into this. Fry this just for about 2 to 3 minutes. The onion and capsicum should not be too much cooked. After 3 minutes, add the Sichuan sauce, around 1.5 tablespoon to 2 tablespoon according to your spice level. If you don't have Sichuan sauce, you can add a tablespoon of tomato ketchup or red chili sauce. Add a teaspoon of soya sauce. Mix this really well. Add a teaspoon of pepper powder, some salt to taste. Add around 2 tablespoons of honey. You can also add a tablespoon of sugar instead of honey. Immediately after adding the honey, add a cup of water. In a bowl, take 1 tablespoon of corn flour and 1/4 cup of water. Mix well and add into this. This step will ensure the gravy is really thick and saucy. See, this has already started getting thick. You can adjust the consistency of the gravy at this stage. You can add more water if you want. If you want it dry, you can let it be like this. But I'm going to add 1/2 cup more of water. Now the sauce is done. Just before serving, fry the potato wedges once again in the oil. By doing this step, the potatoes will be extra crispy when mixed with the sauce. When you feel they are brown and crispy enough, transfer them into a paper towel. Now let's come back to the sauce. Put them back to heat. For the final time, you can adjust the consistency at this point. If you want to add water, you can add now. After adding potatoes, you are not supposed to add any water into this. When this starts to boil, add the potato wedges all together. Mix them gently with the sauce. Turn off the heat after everything is mixed and combined well. Finally, add the fried sesame seeds. This is an optional step. If you have spring onions, you can add at this point to garnish. I just added a teaspoon of roasted sesame seeds. This is all done. Serve this as soon as possible. You can serve this along with any fried rice or noodles, or just like an appetizer. I hope you'll try this recipe at home. If you like it, please don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe to my channel. So until next recipe, bye!